please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Experts who know the numbers at the back of their hand, Nischal Maheshwari of Edelweiss and Gautam Dugar of Motilal Oswal, list out their key expectations from the March quarter. Hear them out.
The face of it doesn't seem to be that there is going to be any kind of a wild card in the current quarter. I think the sectors which are supposed to do well are pretty well defined. I think commodities is going to do well, basically both on the oil side as well as on the metals. The FMCG, the consumers, autos, I think these are three, four sectors which will continue to do well. Sectors which are not expected to do well, domestic investment, exports, especially pharma, and PSU banks and telecom. I think these are the sectors basically which will disappoint the market. We continue to like the large caps, given that the valuations on the large cap IT is still much interesting. Two topics out there are Infosys and Tech Mahindra, in that order. And in the mid-cap space, we like Persistent, but we definitely like the large caps over the mid-caps.
I think market is not, very precariously poised, I would think. Secondly, in terms of numbers, we are expecting around double-digit earnings growth. So we are expecting 11% for our universe and around 13 to 14% for Nifty earnings growth. Within the broad spectrum of sectors, again, consumption is looking extremely good. Autos will have a blockbuster quarter. NBFC will continue to have another strong quarter. We're expecting strong performance in consumption. We're expecting commodity space to do well, both metals and oil and gas, and in fact, utilities also, given that Coal India is expected to do well. Preference continues to remain with retail private banks. In fact, in our model portfolio, we've introduced IndusInd Bank. We've replaced Federal with IndusInd, and we have reduced the overweight of ICICI Bank marginally and added that to the other retail-oriented private banks. I think the real game in financials is happening in NBFCs, where there is going to be another quarter of 30% plus growth, and this has been like the 8th or 9th consecutive quarter where the earnings growth has been extremely steady. And it's very broad-based. I think barring LIC Housing Finance, we're expecting very strong performance across the board. And with bond yield softening, you will find significant interest coming in that space. Metals, I think this quarter is going to have another strong performance across the board again. But I think what we also need to remember in metals case is last four quarters, they've had triple-digit earnings growth. This quarter, they'll have 30%. So growth moderation has set in. Our view has been very cautious on metals. We do believe that one should have booked profits. That's been our view since October, and we don't see any reason right now to change that view.